This is a fish factory, but you don't even know it's there. It's really pretty incredible. This area is the center of the striped bass spawning area for the Choptank River.
How's that?
Striped bass are at the end of all these drainages where the Susquehanna River comes into the bay. That's the biggest spawning area in the world. The Potomac River is the second biggest. One of the things that we are really focused on is how land use impacts fish habitat and fisheries. I think overall the ideal would be a forest, but an agriculture is pretty good. By far the most serious impacts that we've seen are in the suburban and urban watersheds. There's a cumulative stresses that come from development. We had basically a protracted period in the 70s into the 80s of poor reproduction that may well have been linked to inorganic contaminants like heavy metals and possibly acid rain or some other things. And it led to an extended depression of reproductive success, not just for striped bass, but for the other anadromous fish. Several species of herring, American shad, white perch, yellow perch.
Today we will be conducting the striped bass spawning stock survey in the Upper Bay. Part of what I love about it is you just never know what you're going to catch. Striped bass typically begin to spawn around 56 degrees, that's sort of the trigger, and the larger, older fish tend to spawn first. Those 50, 60 pound females or cows can hold 3 to 5 million eggs each. We try to sample all size ranges of the population up here. The tags are used to estimate fishing mortality and survival rates, and we can also get migration patterns and migration rates from the tag data.
We're seeing a pattern now that isn't any different than what was considered the heyday between 1958 and 1970. Seems like a good place habitat-wise right now. The Choptank River's done really well. The key here is simply that this mix of land uses does allow for pretty good habitat for spawning and for larvae of anadromous fish. Some of this too is well thought out growth, trying to conserve as much of these watersheds as you can. The natural features or the semi-natural features even. Sound planning can make a world of difference.